Thank you. imagine what the world would be like if we had no music at all? Listen. Quiet, isn't it?
Listen. Quiet, isn't it?
Let's begin together in Luke's Gospel, chapter 15, and let's begin in verse 11. If you follow along with me, please. Then he said, a certain man had two sons. The younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falls to me. So he divided to them his livelihood. Not many days after, the younger son gathered all together, and journey to a far country, and there are ways to dispossessions with prodigal living. But when he had spent all their own, they did fear famine in that land, and he began to be in want. And then he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into the field of the swan. And he was glad to get filled his stomach with the hog of the swine, and no one would give him anything. The woman came to himself and said, "How many of my hired servants have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with the hunger? I will rise and go to my father, and will say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. And I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants.' And he arose and came to his father. The woman stood in great way off his father, saw him, and had compassion and wrath, and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and at your sight, and I no longer worthy to be called your son.' And the father said to his servants, 'Bring out the best robe and put it on him.
Gosh, I hope she's okay.
Yeah.
Oh, right. Fall off, girl.
Going out of this ministry and holding God's blessing in it everywhere.
slaves! Shut up and save me somebody! Someone's coming to get you all to me! 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 And since you're out of here, I'm going to win! Since you're out of here, I'm going to win! No one's coming to get you! No one's coming to get you! The second time he's promised, everyone's promised. They've had press conferences. I'm sick of press conferences. For God's sakes, shut up and send me somebody.
Thank you. Thank you. Peices, what are you doing out? I thought you were asleep.
I went out to get provisions. I figured we'd be up all night talking.
I'm going to bed.
She doesn't feel like talking.
And I got chocolate macadamia nut cheesecake. And rum raisin ice cream.
Oh, all right. Start cutting, you scoop.
Aw, mother.
So did you decide what you're gonna do?
No. Oh, my luck. The first really wonderful guy I've met in a long time, and he turns out to have a more serious involvement.
With whom?
I'm Dolphin. The church. Or at least he did until he met me.
You know, you take the religious aspect out of this, and it's really quite romantic. A man giving up everything for the woman he loves, kind of like the story of the Duke and Duchess of Windsor.
Or the story of Rose and Charlie Nyland.
You know, when I think of one, I automatically think of the other.
When Charlie and I started dating, I got the feeling that his folks didn't like me. That's when I decided to get to the bottom of things, and I found out about the ancient feud between the Nylands and the Gerklechnabogans.
Gerklechnabogans?
That was my mother's maiden name. Originally, it was Gerklechnabogan-Hoffenstetler-Frown, but they shortened it because most of my mother's family were in show business. Anyway, when Charlie told them that we were gonna get married, they forbade it. They said they'd disown him if he married up. And he'd lose his share of the family Kyle Grout fortune. He didn't care. He told them he loved me more than Grout.
Must have been a tough choice for old Charlie. I thought I heard voices. Now I see that only two of them are God-fearing.
Oh, will you get off my back? I feel bad enough.
You'll burn in hell forever. Sleep tight, pussycat.
I'm going to go to the hospital.